There are a bunch of hidden gems in the Google Workspace admin reports, and I'm going to share with you some of the cool things you can do once you delve into the world of reporting in your Google Workspace account. My name is Pete Moriarty. I help entrepreneurs organize and systemize their businesses and scale using Google Workspace and a number of other tools as well. And in this video, we're talking about reports inside Google Workspace. Now, these are only accessible to admins, and so you need to be an administrator with delegated reporting access. If you want to configure someone to be able to have access to different reports, you can do that via the user groups. Just delegate someone in administration for reports access, and then they can access it. But then once you're in the admin console, admin.google.com, you go to reports, and then user reports, and then we've got all of our different reports here. Now, there's a bunch of reporting, and it can be a little overwhelming just because the number of different options that are here and available. But I've picked out my top eight that our support team have told us that our clients ask about the most. And I'm going to try and wrap these up in, some business advantages here as well for you, so you get a bit of an idea of what people use these for in the real world on a day-to-day basis. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, first report is drive logs, and this one is really useful for security. What this effectively does is it gives you a report on users' Google Drive, and it lets you know what's been happening in each person's Google Drives. So it shows you who's accessed files, who's downloaded files, who's changed files, any edits made, all those kind of things. Now, this is really, really important when you're trying to track down who changed a particular file, or if you've got an employee that you may be a little concerned about, that they may be imminently leaving the business. This is the kind of report that you want to run to see if someone is downloading intellectual property, maybe to their computer, doing a sweep of your drive and downloading things to potentially jump ship from your business. Now, I know that this is the kind of thing that you don't want to have to think about as a business owner, but unfortunately these kind of things do happen. So if you've got anyone that you've got like a gut feeling you might be a little bit suspicious about, this is probably one of the first reports to go ahead and jump into. But of course, it's also useful just as an audit to see who touched what and when, if a file's been lost, if a file's been changed. This gives you one place to see absolutely everything. Next up is two-factor authentication. We talk about this a lot on the channel. Absolutely mandatory to have that enabled. But under security reports, you'll be able to see a verification of how many users are actually enrolled or not enrolled in two-factor authentication. Now, a recommendation is to have this enforced right across the company so that everyone should have it enrolled, but this will give you an idea of who's on and off. And if you're in the process of rolling out two-factor through your organization and you want to make sure that nobody gets locked out of their accounts, or maybe you have an executive, if you're an IT manager and you have an executive you need to look after, you want to see who's enrolled and not enrolled, this is the place where you can go and see that and then help you with the rollout of two-factor. Number three is password security. It will actually show now whether or not your team's passwords are strong or not. So if you don't yet have a password policy set up inside your Workspace account, we've got separate videos on that. It is a recommendation to ensure that everyone has strong passwords and that they change them at least once a year. But if you want to change it more regularly than that, you can have that set up. But this report is a good idea to show you what the current status is of everyone in your company, whether or not their passwords have been set up correctly. Number four, email logs. This is really useful for performance tracking or managing your team. Obviously, you can use features like Google Vault for e-discovery. But what the email logs can be used for is to give you a bit of an idea of volumes right across the business. So you can see, did a user delete an email? Did a user, move something into a folder? Who received specific emails from specific customers? This is useful for troubleshooting things like delivery in and out of the business, basically to see exactly what's going on with your mail flow. Because remember, as Workspace does include productivity tools and file storage and all kinds of things, at its heart, it's an email provider. And so this allows you to basically see all of the mail flow in and out of the business. And there's everything you need to know about email right hidden in this report. Number five, device logs. What this allows you to see is any device that is connected to anyone's account, whether it be a computer, a tablet, a mobile device, someone logging in via the web somewhere, even if they're at the local library. This is going to show you the actual logs of what devices have connected to what accounts. So it's going to give you an idea of what the kind of devices are, the status, when was the last time they checked in and those kind of things. And it's just a good idea to keep in mind that malware is most likely to come from one of these end user devices, particularly if they are a bring your own device. So if someone's brought their own device into the business and connected to business data, this is the most likely place where that's going to come from. So the device logs let you kind of see who's using what devices. And you know, if you've got one staff member that's a bit more lax with their security, maybe they've got three different computers at home and some of them are being used for family stuff and they just kind of leave them on and open all the time. Or you know, you might want to check and see, okay, has anyone logged in to their accounts from different countries? That may be a compromised account where someone's logging in from different countries. So yeah, plenty of options there. That's basically going to show you the device level security for your business. Number six, app usage. This is going to show you who's using how much storage, whether or not you need to potentially purchase additional storage. It's going to show you, you know, what kind of different apps people are using out of the Google suite of tools, which Google apps are people using, which other apps are people using, and which ones are being used the most as well. Now, I find this is really useful for adoption. If you're the person responsible for making sure that your team are actually making the best use out of Google Workspace so you can get the most out of your investment, well, this is an opportunity for you to see exactly how well your team are adopting the tools. I really love this because it gives me an opportunity to see what are the most popular tools that my team might be using, and also opportunities for potential training for the team as well when they may be needed. Now, if you haven't already connected to our Genius Academy, that's a great place to train your team. And we also have live events from time to time. We have an online boot camp scheduled currently. And so you can head along to our website and check that out, or just click onto the links down below and you'll be able to get access to pretty awesome training from our team if you're looking for ways to upskill your team in their adoption of Workspace. Number seven is performance tracking. Performance tracking actually covers app usage again, but it also shows external apps. It shows you how many external apps people are using and having them connected to their Google accounts. Now, if you're in a larger organization, you may be looking at, okay, well, what plugins are staff using? You know, what are they authorizing on their account? What else are they using? That may let you know of shadow IT operations happening. Shadow IT is where a team member signs up to something not sanctioned by the IT team, and then teams just start rolling out software themselves and using them in small pockets across the business. Not always a bad thing, but it's a good idea if you're the person responsible for the tech in the business to be actually monitoring that and potentially looking for opportunities for a useful tool that you could deploy as a policy right across to everyone. But external apps basically let you kind of test and measure and see, okay, well, what's the actual user behavior that's going on here? You know, what are the tools that the team are using and are there potential insights there for productivity for the company overall? Finally, we have a security audit report. What that actually shows you is who's doing things like backups, logging events right across the admin panel. It also shows you even things like down to meeting logs. So, you know, like who started a meeting, you know, who was a part of a meeting, who was inside your Google Meet, you know, including external parties as well. Now, these are the kind of things that might seem a little bit granular and potentially not useful, but let me tell you, the moment you have a legal issue or a customer says, I wasn't in that meeting, or someone says, I was never told that, being able to use these reports as an audit log and actually share them potentially with court system or law enforcement or you know, whatever situation you may be in is very, very important. Particularly when you run into commercial disputes with customers and you want to be able to substantiate if someone was in a meeting or someone was on a phone call, audit reports are a great way to do that, just to cover your butt. So they're the top reports in the Google Workspace admin panel. We use these all the time for things like where there's been a data loss event, trying to work out, well, who touched the files last and who moved them and what's been changed in there. If there's some kind of security breach or cyber attack, this will show us you know, what was or wasn't compromised. If someone gained access to an account of your team unlawfully in some way and you want to see exactly what was done, this gives you a list of absolutely everything that was done. You can also see things like through your drive reports, duplication of files shared outside your company. We have a separate video coming up just on that specifically. And of course, we also mentioned tracking the performance of your team as well. So heaps of options here that you can use in the reports. And if you'd like some help with this, please be sure to reach out to our team. There are links below. If you're new to our channel is all about business and organization, helping you Systemize and Scale, helping you to get your Google Workspace rocking and rolling. If you like this content, hit the subscribe button, give us a thumbs up, and we'd love to see you on the next video. If you're already a subscriber to Google Workspace, you may be interested in our transfer in offer. The link to that is just down below. You get access to our professional training portal with videos recorded for you and your team to learn more about Google Workspace. You also get access to our team to do a health check on your Workspace account. If you'd like a check with some of these reports, we'll be more than happy to do that. And then finally, you get access to our support team for them to help out with basic issues on your account. It's all free. All you need to do is switch your billing to us. Click on the link below to learn more about that, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.